Hey guys, it's Vignesh from CodeAndroid. In this video, we'll see about Room database. Room is a Jetpack library which sits on top of SQLite database and provides all the features of SQLite. At the same time, it allows to access the data without much of the code. Why we need to use Room database? Compile time verification. In SQLite database, if the query is wrong, then it will cause runtime exception, because Android Studio won't do any validation while building the app. But when you use Room database, the queries are validated at compile time, so that it will give the error message while typing the query itself. Boilerplate code. When we use native SQLite, we need to write lots of code to convert cursor object to DTO object. In Room database, we don't need to write any code for this conversion. Internally, Room database itself will handle that. Integration with other components. As it is in Jetpack library, integration with other components like live data or RxJava is simple. Now we'll see the basic components of Room database. There are three components: database, DAO, and entity. First, we'll see about the entity. To create a table in Room database, we need to create a class and annotate the class with @entity. Whatever fields are there in this class will be considered as the column for the table. To create the primary key, we need to annotate one of the field as @primaryKey. In case we want to create primary key as auto-generated number, then we need to set the annotation like this. @primary, inside we need to pass auto-generate equals to true. Database. To create a database in Room, we need to create a class and annotate the class with @database. Inside we need to give two information: what are all the tables should be there inside the database and database version. Here users and credentials are the tables inside the DB, and one is the database version. DAO. This is the place where we do the database operation. To create a DAO, we need to create an interface and annotate it with @DAO. Inside the interface, we need to create the method declaration required for the DB operation. For doing the database operation, we need to annotate the function using one of the following annotation: query, insert, update, and delete. To run a raw query, we need to annotate the function with @query. Inside, we need to pass the database query. To insert the data into database, we need to take the entity object as a parameter, and also we need to annotate the function with @insert, so that Room database handles the insertion. For update also, we need to take entity object as a parameter and annotate the function with @update. Finally, to delete the record from the database, we need to pass the entity object and annotate the function with @delete. In this case, the object which is matching with the primary key will get deleted. In case you want to delete the record using where class, then we need to use @query annotation. That's all for this tutorial, guys. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. If you have any doubts, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.